Hello and welcome to After Before Friday week number 44. This week is a very simple edit taking place entirely in Lightroom, and I'm going to take a few moments to use the spot removal tool. So for those of you who are unfamiliar with it, perhaps you can pick up a tip or two here. I took this photo in my local mall, and it was a storefront, as you can see, opening soon. It was overexposed, but I liked just the black and white of the sign. So that's why I took it. So as I go in to edit this, I'm going to come into the Develop module and go into the Basics panel. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to decrease the exposure. So I'm going to bring it down to about here. And then I'm going to, I don't have a perfect white point or perfect black point. So I'm going to play with the highlights and bring them up a little bit, and I'm going to play with the blacks and, oops, that was the highlights. That's why that wasn't moving. I'm going to increase the whites, and I'm going to decrease the blacks and bring a bit more of the tonal range across the histogram in here. You can also move the values in the histogram by clicking with your mouse and holding and dragging. And you'll see here, as I move my cursor, the labels underneath the histogram, here's the area for the blacks, the shadows, the exposure in here, and highlights, and then of course whites. So most of this, as you would surmise, the histogram falls mostly to the right, but I just increased the shadows and the blacks in the histogram to spread out the tonal range a little bit more. I'm going to open up the shadows a little bit to just bring it a little bit brighter, and then I'll leave it about here. And then I'm going to boost the clarity just a hair. And that deals mostly, you'll see, with the midtones as it slides back and forth on the histogram. So I'm going to bring it up to about here. Okay, spot removal tool in Lightroom is a pretty good tool to use. I used to have to take photos into Photoshop when I wanted to clone or remove some aspect, but this has become a pretty strong tool in Lightroom 5. To access it, you come up here into the right panel and you click on this tool. It's a spot removal tool, and you can set the size and the feather, and you can also set the opacity. One of the things I wanted to remove was the name of my city here, and so I'm going to adjust the size of the tool by scrolling on my mouse wheel and make it smaller and larger. And once I get the size I want, I'm going to left click and I'm going to drag and I'm going to color over it, and I release. And when I do, Lightroom is going to pick another portion of the photo from which to drag a matching area to cover. Now there's two, if I right click on my mouse, it will bring up this menu. You can clone. Let me do this again, or you can heal. And sometimes one works better than the other. Usually I set, I'm going to come back up and I'll show you. Usually I set the feathering pretty high. I'm going to put it here about 88. And you can see that here's what happens when I use the heal approach. Here's what happens. Well, let's see. That's not a very good example. Oh, because it went back down on the feathering. There we go. Clone when my feathering is selected at a high amount, and heal, even the heal isn't working very well. So I'm going to reduce the feathering, and voila, all of a sudden this works. And I'm going to do clone, and let's see. Done. There you go. It has disappeared. Sometimes you have to play around with the sliders, with whether cloning versus healing works better, until you find something that you like. Now, let's try this down here. You see this long line in the poster here that I want to get rid of. So I'm going to come back up to the spot healing. Let's start with a feather up here at 100%, or well, I've got that at 83. Again, I'm going to size my tool. I'm going to left click and I'm going to drag, and then I'm going to let Lightroom pick. Now you can see it's done a pretty good job here, and I can move, I can left click on my mouse and on that little point, and I can move it until it lines up. And let's see, this is a clone. What happens if it heals? Healing, it brings in a little bit of purplish color here, which I don't like. Let's see what happens if I adjust the feathering. See, it's a little bit, it's darker here on the outside edge. So let's go back to clone, and the clone works perfectly. So I'm going to click done. And we've gotten rid of those marks in the picture. Now that I've done that, however, I decided after thinking about what I was going to do in this tutorial that in the end I actually wanted to crop out the portion, the bottom portion of the photo where I had done all the healing and cloning. But that's okay. That gave you a little bit of a lesson in how to do it. I'm going to come up to the cloning, into the crop tool, and I want to do a square crop. And so I click on the one-to-one, and I'm going to pull this all the way up to the top, and I like it just the way it is. I'm going to click done. And the last thing I'm going to do, well, two last things, I'm going to apply a bit of sharpening with a preset, Sharpen JPEG, just a bit. And then I'm going to apply, a post-crop vignette. And I do have some, I do have some presets, and I'm going to, one is heavier than the other. Two is the heaviest. I think I'm going to leave it with two to bring in more of the shadow play in the photo. So quick down and dirty lesson here, and I hope you've picked up some pointers with the spot removal tool. For those of you watching this on YouTube, if you have any comments, you feel free to leave them there on YouTube, or you can visit my blog at visualventuring.com, and you can also see more galleries of after before photos by looking for After Before Friday Forum. Thanks everyone for watching.